Ryan.
Of Ryan.
Adrian.
Tony.
Hi, Jeff.
You guys. Jeff.
Jeff.
Nashville.
Jeff.
Yes.
You guys like Nashville?
Yeah, we love Nashville. It's Ryan's first time.
Really?
Yes.
Yeah.
Awesome. He's a Nash virgin.
Yep. Vegas, not the real Vegas.
No, we got a little bit of Vegas now. In Nashville right now.
Yeah, right with you, right?
Absolutely.
Cool. Okay. I'm a big fan of you guys. I've been able to accept you a few times at festivals and everything.
Aww. Our first fan.
She likes us. She feeds us.
So what are your plans for future albums and everything? What's going on in the works?
September 22nd, 2017, our new album Symbolize.
So
we'll have like a pre-orders through pledgemusic.com where you can get it a little bit in advance. And then July 31st, our new single should be on radio. And,
are we going to hear it tonight?
Maybe. Maybe.
We'll give you a little wink.
Yeah, maybe. Or, possibly.
Right,
but we're going to play a single tune for you guys tonight. So.
Cool.
Yeah.
Yay. What music do you listen to at home?
Tupac.
Really?
And
Really?
So what about you?
Everything.
Yeah.
30 Seconds to Mars and Paramore and whatever.
Cool.
I've been listening to a lot of Talking Heads lately.
Yeah?
Okay, and I kind of got back on Talking Heads too. Because Tony and I were talking about them in their heads.
Our heads were talking to each other.
Yeah.
About Talking Heads.
What about you?
Deftones.
Nice.
That's it.
That's it.
That's all he ever listens to.
Oh. Yeah.
A little Engelbert Humperdinck.
You know, throw that in.
Jimmy Buffett, I'm Parrothead.
How about you?
Look at everything, too.
Otherwise, perhaps?
Yes.
Oh.
I think they're on my obvious.
Nice.
It's cool guys from Vegas. Yeah.
Have you ever been to Vegas?
Yeah. I'm actually from California.
Oh, where?
I went to Vegas all the time.
Yeah. Oh, your neighbors, basically.
Right.
Yeah, we're in California.
Yeah, Sacramento.
Oh, we always call like LA is like basically our second.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
You grew up in Vegas, you know, Los Angeles, Palm Beach, Disneyland, so like 4 hour drive.
Have you guys like born and raised from Vegas?
Yeah. Well, the two of us and then Tony spent like pretty much half his life in Vegas. And Brian's living out of Salt Lake.
Wow, Utah. Wow.
Yeah, I still live there.
Oh, do you?
Yeah. Wow. Can't do that while your guys' legs are this way. Can we all switch?
Thank you. Hey, you're doing the other
everybody,
side.
Everybody in your lock on the door. You gotta look professional. Professional.
So I know that you guys are big into kind of health and like staying in shape. So like, what's like survival tips you have for being on tour on the road?
Like, don't drink.
That's
actually
really
healthy.
You don't
drink at all? Not this one, though.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, we've tried to exercise, at least 2%
Drinking leads to Burger King one day.
Yes.
Yeah.
Or Jack in the Box.
It's a White Castle. White Castle.
You know, the next day, you just feel like hell. It's not. It's the most luxurious of callings to be in a van and going city to city. So, you know, there's not always like.
We did that already on our first tour as signed artists. And I don't know.
All of our tours.
Well, yeah, but the van thing.
Yeah.
You know, the van thing. You know, we scaled back on this tour stream on stuff, you know, and it's just, I don't know how we did that. And I just being drunk every day and then getting in a van. Like, I don't ever want to do that ever again.
You literally don't remember how you did that.
I literally do not remember how.
How long ago was that?
Let's see, we signed
our deal as well. Cool. Let's
see
that.
Yeah.
Don't drink and then try and, you know, stretch and get rest as much as you can. Pick healthier options.
A lot of water. We're doing a lot of pain.
I think it's that eventually once you spend enough time in the van, you just kind of.
have to admit to yourself that you're out on the road and this is your life right now.
Yeah.
It's not like just a temporary, it's not like an escape from home.
Yeah.
It is your home. And so you guys be like, well, if I'm going to get healthy, I have to care enough about it to be like, this is my life, and I have to be like, this is my lifestyle.
Yeah.
Not just, I'll do the workout for a little bit and go back home.
And I can't
believe
I stopped. Keep it going.
Yeah, it's hard, though. For me, anyways.
But there's water and beer, right?
There's
water and beer?
In Miller Lite?
Yes.
Miller Lite is like 95%.
Yeah, vodka water.
There you go.
The ice turns into water.
That's the drink of choice when we're not working.
It's a good choice. So are you two or brothers? So, like,
these two are sisters.
Like, ah! What?
That's twice now I've used that in an interview. That's all. That's good material. Sorry, so what were you saying?
So, how did you come about forming the group?
Well, I was born, and then my brother was born, and our parents introduced us. That's how that happened.
It's like going, hey, bro, let's start again.
I mean, I'm a little bit older than my brother, and so, like, I was working some job doing a bill collection for a cell phone company. I don't know, I just was, like, sitting in my little cubicle, and I just called somebody, and they were like, yeah, fuck you, you know, like, and I think, like, Foo Fighters played, and then Third Eye Blind and Foo Fighters were just back-to-back, and was Learn to Fly by the Foo Fighters. And the office was across from the McCarran Airport, so I could see the plane land and take off. So that was cool. And I don't know, I just was like, dude, I can write a song. And we started learning, we taught ourselves guitar, I mean, basic guitar, very basic. And then eventually, you know, thankfully, it led to us meeting these two talented cats. And you know, things are looking up, things feel really good. For once in a long time.
That's which legs?
Hey, we're all conversing!
Yeah, baby!
So, influences. What band's influence do you have this? Who's somebody that you would really like to tour with?
Satan?
What? You can shred that guy.
Would you like to buy the Kiss or the Saints of Mars? Thrice, Thrice against Deftones and Dust. That's like the coolest two days.
Of course, Foo Fighters. That's like
Foo Fighters. The last time we actually played in Nashville, two of the police were at the show.
Were they?
Yeah. Yeah.
I mean, as far as touring goes, I know we probably never tour with Third Eye Blind, but I would like to just someday sit in a room and maybe write a song with Stephen Jenkins.
Yeah.
And even if we don't use that song, you know, it would still be like, all right, get that.
Yeah.
Influences on our playing?
Yeah, like who influences, like who did you grow up
and
to tour?
YTMK from Rage Against the Machine. And probably flute. There you go. I mean, I'm the bass player, so I get the bass
player. He's also a great guitar player. He's a multi-instrumentalist.
That's cool.
It's all live.
Well, I can only play half the guitar. You can play several instruments.
Okay, half guitar?
I'm just really in first position. I can't go anywhere else.
Okay.
So
CGB.
What about you, Brian?
When I first started playing, Neil Peart was a big
influence to me. Neil Peart.
I don't know, there's been a lot of influences that just inspired me over the years. Non-drummers, just super passionate people. It's inspired me. So, Katy
Perry. I love Katy Perry.
Who doesn't love Katy Perry?
We have about a tour. Yeah. It's a small exit because I have a ticket.
You might have to sell that. You can charge a little extra to sign yourself. Put a $5 up, signature fee. Yeah.
Big foundation,
you
have
one. Oh,
hopefully she's single when she is.
You know what I'm saying?
Right?
Right, Quinn?
Right?
Harry, if you're listening, or watching. What's your favorite city?
Vegas.
I like New Orleans.
That's the second thing. But I love New York City.
San Francisco.
Dubuque, Iowa. Muncie. Yeah, Indiana. North Platte, Nebraska.
Nashville, dude, seriously, Nashville's awesome.
Nashville is
like, thankfully, we're gonna stay part of the night tonight, so Ryan might be able to get down there. Broadway, yeah.
Right up there!
Woo! Yeah, you better see at least once.
No,
Friday and Saturday nights are crazy.
Yeah. My favorite bar on the corner there is next to Legend's. Tootsie's is my favorite spot.
Yeah.
Ryan, go in there and have a beer for me. Winners and losers, yeah, that place is really good.
So, been on tour for about a month now.
Three weeks.
Other bands, everything going good?
Yeah, we've got
Crazy Stories.
Drew Fire and Righteous Vendetta, and it's been really awesome. Coming for the Gods tour 2017. Close to the Gods, yes, yeah, sorry. Close to the Gods. Well, we should have just called the tour that. Close to the Gods, which is a single song off of our new album.
Song
called Close to the Gods. And we really like it. Talks about mortality and, you know, just facing your own, like, I don't know, your own spot in the universe. And so that's what we named the tour, Close to the Gods 2017, and it's been righteous. So Vendetta.
Yeah.
It's not as a, it's kind of like a job for us that we love to do. And the less trouble you get in, the more likely you will succeed.
Craziest story is probably John Davis related. Running into him.
Well, yeah, running into John backstage at Pan the Grass in Seattle was cool. We wrote a song with him called Sleeping Lions. It's the title track of the album. And we ran into him backstage at the festival we just did in Seattle. And it was just awesome. We were like, John Davis. We were talking to somebody else and he walked by and he was like, hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah, he tapped us.
Yeah, and we're like, dude, John Davis just said what's up to us.
Yeah, not your typical rock and roll tour, I don't think. Actually, it's more so the typical rock and roll tour. It's just like,
fail. Everybody's crazy, but
everybody's not that crazy. If you want to succeed, strap your boots down tight. Focus. You cry a lot of homosexuals.
But I guess not.
And several good songs.
Yeah.
That's a Mark project.
Oh my god. we definitely keep the humor flowing.
That's
so.
Good. That's important. What do you guys do back home?
I'm on daddy daycare.
How are you?
So, yeah. Can't wait to get back to the boys.
Play music with my the whole town of Las Vegas.
The entire city, but professional.
There's a lot of cover bands and a lot of other stuff. It's just that I can go make money playing live. Keep it
chopped up.
It's a bunch of stages, a bunch of casinos and rooms and stuff. It's work, man.
You busy here too?
It's all like I have four big dogs, so they keep you busy and always under the mountain.
yoga.
In the last year or so, I kind of love the nonprofit that I'm working on, like music, and trying to understand the nonprofit, you know, corporation and the ins and outs of it. They have something that's legitimate that can actually make a big difference for getting music and instruments and bands. Aside from that, I just go to the gym and pretend to work out.
Just pretend.
Instagram and take pictures
and selfies.
So selfie doesn't count unless it gets on the internet.
That's about it.
Do you guys want to add anything?
Sweet view.
There's trains going back here. But I love trains. There's like a little track right here. Yeah. I hope you enjoy the show.
September 22nd.
Sleeping Lions.
Yes. Thank you very much for talking.
Thank you. You're welcome. Yay, you're welcome, yay.